Hey guys, welcome back to another video. It's Francesco here. So in today's video, I'm going to be looking at Fantastical 3 again. I did a breakdown last week. Many of you may have watched that already. If you have not, you can see that video. But I missed a few things. I missed a few things in terms of talking about the freemium, some of the core features, and also discussing the pricing as well. So in today's video, we're going to jump into all of that, dive over to the laptop, and explain a little more of some of those questions. So without further ado, guys, let's roll into today's video. Okay, first things first, guys, what I wanted to do is clear up the freemium side of stuff. So I didn't actually clearly mention in the first video that Fantastical 3.0 and the new pricing does introduce a free version of the experience. So what you get with the essentials, so the free account is broken up into varying parts. So you do get the ability to add accounts, add events and tasks, delete events and tasks, notifications, show location, event details, and also 3 days worth of weather forecasting and standard email support. And that's in the essentials category. So that almost works in very identical sense to Apple Calendar. So when it comes to a few of the more advanced features, this is where the premium comes in. So what you can't get inside of the free account is full screen day, week, and month, and year view as well. You also do not get the full task support, including iCloud reminders and Todoist. You also only get one set of calendars. So essentially, you won't be able to toggle between certain calendars. One of the features as well that you do not get in the free account is calendar sets syncing. This apparently is the ability to sync calendar sets to all of your devices, including Apple Watch. And you also will not get the time travel and time to leave notifications, as well as interesting calendars. Now, it does become a little bit trickier inside the free account. You do not get as many collaboration abilities. You can't get invitees, scheduling, which means proposed times, Google Hangouts, Google Meet, or Zoom support, combine duplicate events, hide events, and favorite time zones. And you also lack on some of the customization. For example, the templates for events and tasks, which is becoming a very popular feature, custom event colors, custom home screen, for example, the icons on iOS and iPad, as well as custom notification sounds on iOS and iPad. So there are the things that you do get in free. It's mainly the viewing and editing options of each event. So you could use this in a very simple way, you pretty much like you would Apple Calendar. And if you wanted the premium features, they would come at the $39.99 annual price or billed monthly, which I'll include in a link in the description. So just being clear, there is a free experience to Fantastical 3.0 and you can download it down below if you want. So you're probably wondering, what do the premium features look like? And that was one of the many questions. Weather forecasting, you can get up to 10 days. And this is what that looks like. You can basically see the forecast from the AccuWeather for as much as you can within 10 days, which is very helpful, sometimes associating the weather to a certain day, for example, the weekend, what you're exactly going to do is quite useful. So apparently, whatever device you're on, one of the premium features that full screen day, week, month, and year view, which will let you see whatever view you want. You can see a quick overview of the calendar, including the day ticker and calendars view. This will be more highlighted in the iOS tour that we'll do in a minute. So if you're looking to connect up iCloud reminders and Todoist and notifications, again, this is only available through premium, and this is what that looks like. You also get unlimited calendar sets, as well as the ability for the syncing, which is something that a lot of people in the comments were really, really happy for, so that they can have all the calendars synced in real time. You also have travel time and time to leave notifications, as well as interesting calendars. Now, some of the collaboration features, you can invite people, as you can see here, you can schedule and propose times, Zoom support, combining duplicate events, hide events, favorite time zones, which is all very useful, as well as the template functionality. So there's some of the premium features that a lot of people were talking about. Okay, so one of the many questions that you guys had was, what does the Fantastical 3 iOS application look like? And as you can see, this is what it looks like in Premium. It's got this really nice day ticker view, allowing you to essentially see what's coming up. You can scroll ahead, and you can even see all of the events, as well as any apps you've connected to the experience. Now, as you can see up here, we're currently in day ticker view, but you can also view the tasks only or calendar only, as well as the day, week, month, and year. And again, these full screen views are only available in Premium. Okay, so inside of the Premium, this is the full screen views. As you can see here, you can basically see a really nice clear view of the day. You can also scrabble to the week view, which is something that is available in other apps like Woven and Calendars 5. However, it does look nice and clean and easy to view. But again, a lot of people would argue this is currently available in Apple Calendar. You can also get month view as well, something that I don't particularly like, but I know a lot of people enjoy it. And also year view as well. Again, a bit like the heat map that we demonstrated in Fantastical 3 Breakdown. So that's really nice in being able to see your tasks. This pulls in all of the iCloud reminder tasks as well. But what I did notice is I am signed in on my Todoist on the Mac version, but they aren't pulling the tasks in that I had from that version. So there may be a syncing issue that might need to be solved here. So you're probably wondering, what does the Apple Watch version look like? So the Apple Watch version looks like this, and they've tried to keep the design very similar. Now, apparently the syncing works on this one as well. And again, this will be more of a premium experience. So you'll get all the cross-platform abilities inside of the premium edition. You can scrabble through, which is really nice, and you also get the plus button, which allows you to add using intelligent input, very similar to dates, smart date parsing, allowing you to add an event really easily. You can also change that to a task if you wanted to. Now down here, once you've set up templates, you could quickly access one for a specific event or a specific task, allowing you to essentially, if you wanted to, say, organize a Monday morning meeting, you could quickly do that using that template. So I had a look, guys. A lot of you guys questioned, do I get the upgrade if I was on Fantastical 2 and already paid? According to their FAQ, all the features from Fantastical 2 are automatically available and do not require a Fantastical Premium subscription. This is only available to existing Fantastical 2 customers. So anything you've had in version 2 and you sign in, you'll get everything you had before. However, if you want any of the new 3.0 features, then you'll have to upgrade. So they mention here there are also new features available for the free to existing Fantastical 2 Cut users. You can see there that there's anything from the weather to the Todoist support, the parser upgrades, the autocomplete recommendations, as well as some of the iOS, Mac, and iPad specific updates. So that's something to note for anyone that is a Fantastical 2 user, something I should have mentioned in the last feature. So I actually had a lot of questions about the pricing, and a lot of people were sort of biting back in the comments about the pricing being too much, and I totally agree. Sometimes once you've paid for an application like that for such a long time, say you've done a one-off and you've kept it for about 3 or 4 years, it's sort of like a bonus because you're actually getting a pretty fantastic deal. If you're paying $49.99 and you had that application for 3 years, only works out to about $15 to $20 a year, which is fairly reasonable for a calendar application. Now, a lot of applications are heading in the subscription model way, and I think that this is almost pretty much a certainty that this will happen in the future. But the thing I'd say is that it really depends on whether you use a calendar as much as this. For example, some people use email quite aggressively, and you can get email for free for $0 on Gmail. But a lot of people are looking at Superhuman, Missive, and other paid email applications because the experience is far superior in terms of design, the quality and the support that you have with those applications. So people are paying from, you know, between $30 a month and $100 a year on email. So it's the same with Calendar. If you value Calendar a lot, if you time block a lot, if you have lots of meetings, if you manage, for example, Zoom calls, Google Calendar invitees, then this $40 is going to go a long way for the year. But I feel like, in a way, I feel like Fantastical 2 users should have been upgraded to 6 months worth of premium instead of necessarily just getting all the existing features. Maybe they should have added on that 6 months for the extra loyalty. And I guess this sort of came out of the blue. Maybe I didn't check in on some of the news, but I guess they just sort of chucked this on us as they did this new release. Sort of felt like they were getting the subscription out before actually just releasing it. But overall, I think Fantastical is a fantastic calendar application, in my opinion. It's a solid application. It's pretty much Apple only, but it is a good application. I'd really love to hear some of your thoughts. I read all those comments and I agreed with a lot of the points there. And thank you very much to the likes of Adrian on Twitter, who mentioned about my review not being fair, because I wanted to make sure I covered all of those points. So hopefully I did do that in today's video. If you're brand new here, do subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers, everyone. Bye.